Congratulations, yeah, Damaren.
So cute.
Yeah.
All right, can you take this? I'm about to come.
I know, it's okay. I have a feeling. All right, our Lady Peace is here with us this morning ahead of a performance tonight at CMAC, opening for, we're taking you back to the 90s, Bush and Live. We're joined by band members Steve Mazur and Jason Pierce. Thank you so much for being with us.
Thanks for having
us. We've been having a great time talking about, like, 90s music and the bands that we remember, the songs we remember, and just, you know, how we got into the 90s. And you so eloquently expressed the sound of the 90s, because you and I grew up, you know, in the 80s.
Yep.
We grew up to, you know, listening to 80s rock.
MTV generation.
And MTV yep. generation. And then the 90s happened, and it was like, you know, Nirvana.
Like a reaction
and everything changed.
Yeah, yeah. yeah. Reaction yeah. against all the hairspray bands and everything. Everyone wanted
not
to
so much
of,
hairspray anymore, a yep. little grungier, a little edgier,
yep.
right?
Yeah. yeah. And so it was a very fertile
angry.
Time for music.
yeah.
And all the parameters were broken wide open then. And so you had a lot of great music, Soundgarden, like we were talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
Alice in Chains, mm-hmm. Pearl Jam, Stone Temple Pilots.
Stone Temple Pilots. Yeah, oh, my God.
Totally.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, Pearl Jam.
So you guys said that on the road, you've just been traveling, so you're just going to sleep when you're here. You're not going to get a chance to check out our city?
I mean, there's always the House of Guitars question when you're
there
here.
There you go.
Know?
You got to get
there. Do you want to know? I grew up behind the House of Guitars.
Really?
That
really?
Was my... That was where we went to get music when I was a kid.
That's
I used
amazing.
To go in
Still
there,
the place
and a guy
right?
from the Chesterfield Kings used to work the desk, and I'd go in there asking for my little Michael Jackson or, you know, my Wham, you know, whatever, Metallica, and he's like, you know, here you go, you know, and I'm like, but yeah, House of Guitars, oh, that's a destination.
So my might need to rally, yeah, I might need to get a lot of caffeine and forget the sleep and
yeah.
and caffeinate for the
but
show.
We want you to have a good show tonight, though, so too, we want you to be well-rested.
Yeah,
we'll
there's
see.
A balance.
Yeah, we'll have to look, but yeah.
When do you get a chance to rehearse? I mean, you know, like, when do you do that? Like, an hour before the show? Are you just sort of ready to play all the time, or?
Actually, right before we came back out on this run, we did a day of rehearsals. So not, yeah. we don't rehearse a lot because we're kind of split between Los Angeles and Toronto.
Yeah, so it's hard to get together.
Totally, but we always make time.
Yeah, you just do it. It's kind of funny when you're on the road. It's not like, I think people think sometimes, oh, you have all this time to rehearse in this space and all these things. It's
not
a
like
little
that.
More grassroots than that. Sometimes mm-hmm. it's the back lounge of the bus with an acoustic guitar. Hey, let's change the way we're doing this tonight. Mm-hmm. Let's do it like this. And you sit there with a couple guitars in the back lounge of the bus, and all of a sudden you're on stage in front of 3,000 people,
yeah.
hoping what you did in the back lounge of the bus works out on stage.
Totally.
And most of the time it does.
Wow.
Sometimes we won't name
it
shows.
Goes left sometimes.
Yeah, yeah.
yeah.
But.
You guys seem so nice and genuine. Do you have a chance to interact with your fans at all?
We normally do a lot. Yeah, this tour is so far, it depends on the venue. Like when we're doing clubs and the buses right outside in the street, then you really get to interact with the fans a lot. This tour we're playing, you know, sort of the amphitheaters, so it's
right.
you're a little more removed. But usually, yes, and we have awesome fans that like legitimately care about us, which is pretty awesome when you're away from home and stuff.
Totally.
They bring us cookies and things like
that.
Oh,
that's awesome. Okay, can we get a little personal with you?
Of
I know
course.
You're expecting a child, a
I
son,
am.
And I asked, since you play drums, you got the drumsticks ready for him. And because we were talking about music and maybe kids, you know, picking up what you know, the adults do, what
totally.
We do. Yeah.
Yeah, that would be amazing. It would be amazing to see, like, another generation come from within and actually take over that way, you know? And as we were saying before, too, like, hopefully he's not into sports. I'd be, you know, up the...
And that's a game changer.
You didn't play football and
no,
basketball?
No, I didn't play anything.
yeah.
No, I ran the radio station
Did
in
you
my high school.
Did you? Been in
so.
Music.
Yeah.
Have you all just always, both of you, been that way? Just musically inclined?
I was a sports kid up until about seventh grade. Guitar took over.
Yeah.
You know, when the Chili Peppers were out. I was like, okay, no, forget basketball. Forget all that. I'm
yeah.
doing this. Yeah, yeah.
You could have been playing for the Clippers or the Toronto Raptors. If you never
I
know.
To be honest with you, the way those guys' schedules are, like, I'm really into baseball, and the way, like, you know, people say, oh, your schedule must be tough. Professional athletes, man, that is a schedule right
yeah,
there.
Yeah, I still marvel at, you know, musicians who travel and like yourself, and then you're not even in the same city half the time. So, again, come on out and see our Lady Peace. Great guys, great music, great sound. Going to take
it
way
you.
Back.
Yeah, it was really nice chatting with you guys. Oh,
thanks for having
thanks
us.
For getting
having
up
us.
Early
yeah.
for us.
Thank you. Yeah, we appreciate it. This was really fun.
Yeah. Rock out.
Local headlines next.